hello everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Zachariah the Ghost. I'm back again with another video, and this time I'm driving from Santon to Hoodmead. I call this series K53 Road Signs Simplified, and I'm driving around different places, showing you traffic lights, showing you traffic circles, showing you speed humps, showing you different road signs and road markings. But the most important thing that I want you to learn is to check how other drivers are behaving on South African roads, simply because of sooner or later you guys will be driving on these roads. So you need to see the roads, check our conditions of our roads, check how others are behaving. And before I forget, please subscribe to the channel. Let's get this channel to 1k subscribers. I know it's possible, I know we can do that. And you are going to see different types of traffic lights. Others have, you know, arrows, flashing arrows, others they don't have. And I see people are still having these big debates. You know, others are saying, even if the traffic light is red, you can still proceed if you're turning left and it's safe to do so, which is very wrong. And by now, I think you guys know how the traffic lights operate. In South Africa, we call traffic lights robots. And remember, traffic lights has only three colors. We have the red color, we have green and amber. Others are saying it's yellow, others are saying it's orange. And I want to talk about something. As you see, you know, this car behind me stopped there and proceeded. There is a broken line there that allows you to proceed without stopping if it's safe to do so. So I'm going to speak about different, you know, things on this video. You know, this is what we call a lane, to those who don't know. You see, we have multiple lanes. You see on my right, you can see the arrow, which is pointing that you can use that lane if you are turning to the right. You see, we have three lanes which are heading to the same direction. And you must always pay attention to the road markings. Pay attention to the road markings, simply because of these arrows are a language, you know, they're communicating with you. Because I see people involved in car accidents, you know, unnecessary. You see, now I'm turning to the right, I'm using the right lane. This person just decided to go, you know, the light is red. But the person just decided to go simply because of now, he or she saw that, you know, the cars on the other side, you know, they stopped simply because of the light is red for them. But we need to do things the right way. There are those who think they are clever, they want to beat the robot, they want to beat the traffic light, but it is not the right way of doing things. You see, now it's changing. You see, there is a flashing arrow there that allows me to turn. So time after time, you will come across, you know, the outlaws, the bad boys, those who doesn't want to follow the rules of the road, those who doesn't want to follow, you know, the road signs. But you must always remember that you're not driving only your car. You need to be aware of other vehicles around you, simply because of you might be, you saw that, you know, road sign there, it shows you that there will be a traffic light. Here it is. If you pay attention, your driving becomes easy. Then you can know what to do. You saw there, it shows us that, you know, there is a speed camera around there. And there are so many, you know, road signs. Oh, these guys, man. These guys with the trolleys, I mean, they must create a lane for these guys. They are everywhere. There are so many road signs that, you know, they added from the road signs that we knew. And those who did, you know, their driver's licenses in those years, like in the 1980s, 1970s, you know, they're going to struggle a lot with this new road signs. But I'm going to show you, because from Woodmead, there is the other one that I saw there, and I'll show you that road sign. We will talk about it. I saw, oh, look at these guys, man. These guys are looking for a job. It is tough. It's early in the morning and these guys already, they are there. They're looking for garden part-time jobs. Or even if it's a full-time job, it's not a problem. As long as they can come in and do your garden. Or if companies are hiring. I remember back in the days, I used to be in that situation, whereby you just wake up early in the morning, go to places like Isando, Spartan, Olifantsfontein, Elandsfontein, Jamestown, you know, Jet Park, looking for a job. Sometimes, you know, a truck can just stop there and they tell you that they're looking for two people or four people to go and offload the container. Sometimes, you know, a person can just walk by and tell you that, look, man, I need someone to come and help me. And in that way, at least you get something. You get a peace job. You can go home and buy something to eat. You know, God is great. God is amazing. And sometimes when we are dealing with those kind of problems, we think maybe it's the end. But God knows, man. I'm saying this because I know some of you guys, you are working on your driver's license. Some of you guys, you don't even know how you're going to finish, you know, this project that you started or this process of getting a driver's license, simply because of you don't have enough money. You don't know how are you going to, you know, afford to book for a truck. You don't even have money to pay for extra lessons. And driving schools, in most of the time, they're not going to give you a truck without taking few lessons. And which is something that we must talk about. I should create more videos whereby I can just share some information so that you will know what to expect when you're done with your learner's license. And I have to say this again. You don't need driving schools for a learner's. If you don't have enough money, don't stress yourself. You saw there, I just turned to the right simply because of the flashing arrow was amber. The red light was red. If I was proceeding straight, I was supposed to stop. But now because of I was turning to the right and the flashing arrow allows me to turn. So you must always pay attention. And also we must also speak about, you know, this painted Iceland where you see, you know, the yellow lines there and the white lines. I remember one day I asked someone, what does these lines mean? And the person told me that I just see paintings, you know, on the floor. I just don't know what it mean, you know, and the person was telling me the truth. And why is that person not knowing what this painted Iceland mean? is simply because of when they go to driving schools or when they prepare to get, you know, a driver's license or a learner's. There are certain things that they don't even care much about them. They're just telling them, or they just know that they will learn those things while they're busy driving. And they're focusing on the most important things so that they can pass a test, so that they can have a driver's license. I used to think it's a good thing to do. I used to think it's smart, but it is not. Simply because of now, you are owning this driver's license, but there is so much that you don't know. And you might find yourself driving on the opposite direction, and that might be very dangerous, whereby you might involve in a very serious accident. So every time you see those lines, that means you are not supposed to drive on the other side of that yellow line. Those yellow lines are dividing the lanes. They are dividing the roads. So you need to know that these lanes are heading to this direction. So on the other side of those painted Iceland, you need to know that vehicles will approach on the opposite direction. They will be facing you. So if it happens that you switch lanes and you go to this other side of those painted Iceland, the yellow lines, that means you are going to get the oncoming traffic. So it's going to be a problem. You might be involved in a head-on collision. So you don't want that. And I know nobody speaks about them. I must just create a video where I will show you all the painted Icelands to different places and speak about them. Yes, I know there is the box that you see there where it controlled traffic. This is not that box. It's a different one. So we need to speak more about those things. And now, speaking about the box, also when you are doing the air test, you know, there is this box that you need to know. I must also speak about it too. We need to share information, guys. We need to share information if we want to get better, if we want to pass our driver's licenses. It's a teamwork. Don't forget that. It's a teamwork. See the red light? I mean, the traffic light is red. That's the reason why you see all these cars, you know, stopped there. So once it turns green, we will proceed. See that car that turned to the right? Is because of the flashing arrow allowed that car to turn to the right hand side. This is wood meat, by the way. I was there to buy meat at Macro. Saw some great, you know, deals there. You see that triangle shape there, and there is a broken line. It shows you that, you know, it is not a must for you to stop. You can proceed if it's safe to do so. It's a yield sign. This is Macro at Woodmead. You know, time after time you will see pedestrian crossing simply because of, you know, people will cross there. It is cross from, you know, the parking, go into the store. See these brothers here, man, they're also working hard to making sure that, you know, they help us to park our cars. I always feel guilty.